Hey guys, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. So the diagram that you see at the bottom of your screen right now is generally the most common way that guitar players will get their scales. It's likely that you may even recognize this shape if you've practiced the major scale. Now, patterns like this can be okay for plotting scale notes or if you're learning about the geometrical layout and the scale degrees, but if you want to actually play and use scales, there is a better way to work on them. And in this lesson, we're going to cover an important method that's also a fast method to have scales working for you. So let's get things started by playing through an example of how this method works. A lot of guitar players, they just start out by playing in position scales. And this is okay. I mean, it's nice chops building work. You know, it's okay for left and right hand coordination, but it doesn't get you to playing melody very quickly. Now, if you take arpeggios, though, if you build through an arpeggio method that's diatonic, you can play across each of those arpeggios. Let's say I'll pick four. I'll go from G to A minor, B minor, and C major. You can hear they sound really nice. It's a great practice approach. And if you take a G major chord, I've got one in my looper pedal here. I'll just play that, give you a chance to hear that go by. And then I'll play all these arpeggios under that chord. It sounds really nice. Check it out. They connect extremely well. Now on top of that, you can do some line building with a couple of arpeggios. I'm going to take a B minor and an A minor, and I'll do a little guitar lick idea here. Check it out. Just simple work like that, and you know, in no time, you're going to be playing melodies just using arpeggios of the key. All the arpeggios work because it's diatonic, and you can play them pretty much over any chord. So I'll get you that jam loop in the Patreon download if you're a Patreon member, but you can even just keep things really simple, record a G chord or something, and have some fun with this. It's a great way to connect into the key with wider intervals that'll help you have a much faster connection to melody. Coming up next, I'll get into a few more ways that expand on the diatonic arpeggio idea by using the arpeggios to create wider intervals and more interesting melodic options. But first, I want to tell you about a promotional offer I'm running for my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here, and if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale, and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5 or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. The diatonic arpeggios of a key operate across the entire fretboard within a scale pattern, and they can be organized for every chord that relates to the key. We're practicing our examples within G major, and this means that the upper range of arpeggios in the second position of the scale can offer us access to a couple of cool sounding arpeggios, and those are going to be dominant seventh as well as the sound of diminished. So let's study these arpeggios next. The last arpeggios that we have to complete the key will take in some dominant 7th, minor 7, minor 7 flat 5 chords. We're going to have D dominant 7, E minor 7, F sharp minor 7 flat 5, and then we'll have G major 7 once again, just up at the higher register tones. Now these are all diatonic, so even though the D dominant 7 and the F sharp minor 7 flat 5 are rather dissonant, they do still fit. You know, they're still going to sound fine when you play them over any kind of other chord in the key. Now I've still got that loop in my pedal of the G major 7 from our first example. So I'm going to turn that on, and over top of that G major 7 chord, I'm going to perform all these other arpeggios. Check it out. Sound really nice in there. Check it out again. I'll play it one more time. Now, I also put together a guitar lick for you. It takes into consideration E minor 7 and the G major 7. Check it out, I'm gonna play it now. It's got some triplet feel to it. Here it is. So you can tell I'm playing an E minor 7 in there to get started over this G major 7 chord, and it sounds perfectly fine. So if you want to learn a little bit more about the details behind the music theory of this stuff, it's probably a good idea to join my Patreon, because in that video I go into real in-depth on why this system of diatonic arpeggios works so well and gets you playing melody so much faster using the scale tones. It doesn't have to be, you know, licks that you work out and get from other players or anything like that. If you get accustomed to these arpeggios and how they sit through the scale, you're going to have way faster access to melody. Before we wrap things up, let's look at one other way to practice these diatonic arpeggios. The next approach focuses on the upper strings, with arpeggios moving a little more laterally along the neck. All the arpeggios still connect into each chord of the key, but these won't be locked into just one position. Let's check out these new shapes. So the next approach that I have is going to take us far more laterally along the neck. A lot of our focus will just be on the top four guitar strings only, because I want to get this motion traveling more lateral along the fingerboard. So what we're going to do is cover the whole key. We'll do all the chords for the key. We're going to start out with the G major 7, A minor 7, B minor 7, and C major 7, going like this. Then what we're going to do is leave that area and jump forward to the 10th fret position pretty much. And we're going to be coming from 4th string, doing D dominant 7, E minor 7, F sharp minor 7 flat 5, and then finally the high G major 7 up here. So you get quite a few different options of fingerings, and because we're moving so much, you know, across the fingerboard like that, you're going to get different locations to help get you more familiar with how these are operating on the neck. Now, that loop that I had from our first example and second example, that's just that G major 7 chord, if you'll remember. I can use that in the background and practice all of these arpeggios over. Check it out. It's a really great exercise. Here we go. Shift positions up here. You can tell it's a really nice way to practice this. It's excellent how it harmonizes against that main root chord of the G major 7. And, you know, this type of practice, to get into a habit of doing it as much as you can, will not only tune up your ability to understand notes on the neck, the sounds of the arpeggios for the keys, but it'll help you get more tuned into intervals and phrases that can be used over top of all the chords of the key. And it'll just make you a better musician. You'll be able to lift parts off albums easier. It's going to have so much of a broad-based effect on you. It's just excellent work. So if you want to get more of the in-depth theory of this down, remember to sign up for my Patreon page, because the Patreon bonus video for this lesson is going to cover an in-depth theory breakdown of exactly why this is so effective and the theory behind how it actually works. Well, as always, there is a Patreon video for this lesson, and in it, I'm going to show you a lot more about melodic application when you're using this arpeggio method. I'll also include a detailed theory lesson and a melodic example that actually applies this approach. Also, keep in mind that Patreon members always get a detailed PDF handout of the entire lesson. That includes everything on YouTube and then everything that we're going to do on Patreon. And along with that, if that wasn't enough, you're also going to get a jam track to practice at home with. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month member today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, the curriculum is all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got a complete beginner's program. There's an excellent intermediate guitar course and a fantastic advanced guitar program. On top of that, you'll get access to an acoustic guitar program. There is guitar technique, guitar soloing, music reading, ear training. There's tons of courses, and you all get access to that for one price. So go check it out. It's at creativeguitarstudio.com. And plus, you're going to want to make sure you've seen my lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.